Welcome back to your free training course for the Windows 7 7680 exam. In this video, I will continue to look more into NTFS permissions, covering the advanced features NTFS can offer. Before I get started, I want to first look at something not covered in our sharing video and NTFS video. This is how share and NTFS permissions work when combined. Put simply, when these permissions are combined, the most restrictive permission wins. Given this example, if the share permissions are set to full control on the share, and the NTFS permissions are set to read, the user will only ever have read access to the file. The fact that they have full control at the share level does not give them more rights. This also applies in reverse. If the share permissions are set to read and the NTFS permissions are set to full control, again, the effective permission for a file or folder would be read. When you are dealing with NTFS and sharing permissions together, simply ask yourself which is the most restrictive permission, and this will tell you what permissions the end user will get. In the last video, I looked at the standard NTFS permissions, which gave you 6 basic permissions you could choose from. If you need more control over your files and folders, you can assign them advanced permissions, often referred to as special permissions. This gives you 13 permissions to choose from. These 13 permissions map to the 6 basic permissions covered in the first video. First, you have the read permission. When you assign the read permission to a file or folder, you are essentially assigning it the following 4 permissions. The first permission is list folder read data. If applied at the folder level, it will allow you to see the file name of any file or folder regardless of the permissions on the file or folder. If you want to make a submission folder, a folder in which people can drop files but not see the files that have already been written to the folder, you could clear this permission. If this permission is applied at the file level, this gives the user the ability to read data in the file. The next permission is the read attributes permission. This gives the user the ability to read the basic attributes of a file or folder. This includes the read-only, hidden, and archive attributes. The next advanced permission that is set when selecting the basic read permission is read extended attributes. Extended attributes are set by programs and may vary from program to program. The last permission set when selecting read is read permissions. This allows the user to read the NTFS permissions but not make changes. You can see from assigning the basic read permission in NTFS, you are in fact setting 4 of the advanced permissions. In most cases, assigning the basic permission will work fine. In some rare cases, you will need to configure the permissions on a more granular level than setting basic permissions allows. If I now look at the basic write permission, this is also assigned to 4 of the advanced permissions. The first is create files write data. On the folder level, this gives you the ability to create files in the folder. If you don't want to allow creating of new files, edit the existing folder permissions and clear this permission. If you apply this permission to a file, this permission allows the user to write to the file. The next permission is create folder append data. This permission, when applied to the folder level, allows the user to create new subfolders in that directory. When it is applied at the file level, it allows the user to append data to the end of a file, but not to change any existing data. If you had a log file that you wanted to ensure was not changed after it was written to, you would select this permission and clear the write data permission. The next permission is the write attributes permission. This allows the user to change the basic file attributes on the file, such as read-only, hidden, and archive. The last permission is write extended attributes, which allows the user to change extended attributes set by programs. The next of the basic permissions is list folder contents. this permission is only available at the folder level. This permission sets the traverse folder permission and the four read permissions. The traverse folder permission allows a user to go through directories even if they don't have access to them. For example, let's say a user does not have permissions to a folder. This would also mean that they could not access any folders below that folder. However, by giving them traverse permissions, they could access any folder under the folder that they do not have access to. Simply put, they can have access to a folder lower in the folder hierarchy if they knew it was there, even when they don't have access to the folders above. When you select List Folder Contents, it includes all the permissions set when you select the basic read or write permission. The next basic permission is read and execute. When this basic permission is set, it applies all the advanced permissions above it on both the folder and the file level and adds the execute files permission when applied to files. The execute permission allows the user to run executable files. This does not include scripts and other files that are essentially run by another program. Think of it like this. If the file can be opened using the file open command from another program, or dragged and dropped on a program to open or run it, then it is not an executable file. The next basic NTFS permission is modify. This includes all the above permissions and adds the delete permission. The delete permission does just that. It allows you to delete a file or folder. You can probably start guessing that using the advanced permissions gives you a lot more control over files than using the basic permissions. Using advanced permissions, you can give the user the ability to read files and delete files, but not change files, something that is not possible using the modify permissions. The last of the basic permissions is full control, which adds three advanced permissions. This first permission adds the ability to delete extended attributes created by applications. The next permission is change permissions. This allows the user to change the NTFS permissions that have been assigned. The last of the advanced permissions is the take ownership permission. This allows a user or users to change the owner of a file or folder. The owner of a file or folder has the ability to change the NTFS permissions even if they do not have access to the file. I will now change to my Windows 7 computer to demonstrate advanced NTFS permissions. First of all, I will open Windows Explorer and go to the properties of a directory I created called NTFS Advanced Permissions. Once in the properties, I will go to the Security tab. First of all, I will edit the standard permissions to demonstrate a point. I will change the permissions for users to list folder contents. Now if I go back and select the button Advanced and select the permissions for users, it will show it has the permissions of list folder contents, but also it applies only to this folder and subfolders. For files in the directory, it gets all access for the entry below it. Notice that the permissions in this case are called special. These are applied to the folder, subfolder, and file level. This essentially means the files don't have execute access. To show this a bit clearer, if I press the button Change Permissions and then select this entry and press Edit, you will notice that Traverse Folder Execute File is not ticked. This entry will make sure that files in this folder do not have the execute permission. If I were to add this permission back in and go back to the previous screen, I now have one entry, that is, read, write, and execute. You will notice that when you edit permissions, if the edit matches a basic permission, it will be displayed as that basic permission. If Windows cannot match the permissions to a basic permission, the entry will be listed as special. If I go back in and edit the permissions, notice that I can apply this permission to a number of different places. First, the folder level, and then every combination of folders, subfolders, and files down to files by themselves. This gives you a lot of control. For example, you could create a folder where users could only access files in that folder, but could not access any data in any of the subfolders. You may be thinking, I could just create these folders myself and then assign permissions to them. By doing it this way, it gives you more control over new files and folders that are created and also gives you the ability to manage the permissions of the folder, files, and subfolders from one point. In this example, I will create a folder in which users can place files but not delete them. Also, they will be able to list any files that are in the folder. Once I enter in the permissions, they will appear as special permissions. Remember that the permissions a user receives are a combination of the groups they are in. If I select the tab Effective Permissions and then enter in a user account, notice that the user still has permissions to everything, even though I just assigned them special permissions. The Effective Permissions tab is a good way to troubleshoot the permissions allocated to a user. If I go back to the Permissions tab, notice that Authenticated Users has been given Modify Access. This is where the user is getting their permissions from. To fix the problem, I simply need to remove this entry. Now if I go back to Effective Permissions and select the user again, this time the user has the special permissions that I configured earlier. In this video and the last video, I looked at configuring NTFS permissions. NTFS permissions help protect your files from unauthorized access. In the next video, I will look at how to configure encryption on your files. Encryption is another method you can use to protect your files. For more free videos for this completely free Windows 7 training course, check out our website or YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.